Hello, today I'm going to present my lab work about silicon-based anode material for lithium-ion batteries. For that, I will start by an introduction, then experiment and result, and I will finish by conclusion. Most battery anodes are mainly composed of graphite. So far, this technology has reached their maximum energy density, and the limiting factor here is the graphite anode, which is able to hold a limited number of lithium ion. In other hand, we have silicon as the second abundant element in the earth. It's obvious that silicon has theoretical capacity very higher compared to conventional graphite. That's because one silicon atom can hold more than four lithium ions. Not only silicon can increase the total energy density, but it's also very cheap, which will dramatically decrease the price of battery. So why we don't use silicon as anode material? Silicon has a big problem, which is the large volume expansion during lithiation, and when the particles expand and contract, it causes delamination from the electrical contact. In addition, we have unstable SOE layer due to the volume expansion. For our case, we have made silicon carbon composite by polymerization of resin cyanide and formaldehyde to get 3D network gel polymer. We have made a suspension of silicon particle in the formed gel, but before we need to have a small size particle of silicon to have a stable suspension, so that's why we have grinding them. After having the suspension, we dry it in oven at 80 degrees C. After that, we have carbonized the system in argon foil at 650 degrees for 5 hours. Here you can see the general process, and the objective was to have a carbon as buffer matrix for the volume expansion. From the TGA analysis, we get 15% of silicon in our composite. Here you can see the Raman spectra of silicon carbon composite and pure silicon for comparison. There are two main peaks which correspond to the D band and G band, and you can see also the presence of SE band at very lower intensity. We have sensitized three different electrodes, pure silicon, pure graphite, and silicon carbon composite, by mixing them with 5% of CMC binder and 15% of black carbon. Here you can see in the left the charge and discharge curve of graphite anode over 25 cycles. We have a reversible capacity and higher coulombic efficiency. And you can see clearly what we get for the pure silicon. The capacity falls over 100 cycles, and we obtain a dramatic decay of capacity during cycling, which is due to the volume expansion of silicon. For silicon carbon composite, we get a good result for the few first cycle, as you can see in the charge and discharge curve for rate C over 5, over 10, and over 20. The cyclic voltammetry show two main peaks, which correspond to the alloying and the alloying of silicon carbon composite. As conclusion, we can say that silicon carbon shall motivate the result. We need to perform SEM characterization, and we can optimize the silicon carbon ratio, and we can use additive for better results. That's all, and thank you for your attention.